bargaining with somebody and pay. And yeah, so we bargain with somebody and we take 5 to 6 rupees per kg or something. But trust me, it's a very big business what happens through scrap. Now, when I was doing article ship, we had client, ITC was our client, and I'd gone to Mettupalayam, which is near Coimbatore. So these people make paper boats, right? So they used to import scrap from US because the cost of import was less than cost of procuring scrap in India. So can you imagine the scrap is making their, and that was, I guess, their seventh largest business or something. That was making some multi-million dollar. I'm talking 7 years down the line. 7 years ago, it was making some $1 million. So that is the power of covering things in the scope, right? Next is consignment. So for example, I'm from Gadag and you guys are from Hubli. So if I tell you, hey, boss, take these mobile phones and you sell it in Hubli. Whatever sells, you sell, and whatever doesn't sell, I'll take them back, right? So do I have to charge VAT for everything what I give you or only what you sell? This is again a confusion. And then comes job work. Say I'm a shirt manufacturer, for example, and you are a buttoning master. Buttoning master are people who put buttons in shirts. And I give you buttonless shirts and tell you, please button them and give it back to me. So do I have to charge VAT? And do you charge me VAT when you give them back to me? So all these confusions are there, and already our courts are filled with cases, right? So the government didn't want more and more cases to pile up. So what it told us, the government told to us, we are not anymore focusing on purchase and sale. They're only talking about supply. And when I tell supply, everything gets covered in supply. Purchase, sale, transfer, gift, consignment, job work, everything is covered in supply unless I specifically exclude it. I mean government. So government tells, if there is a movement of goods, okay, if something has gone from here to there, it is a supply. But only if I tell that GST is not applicable on this, then you have to not charge GST. Otherwise, question remaining silent, or the fact remaining silent, it has to be taxable, right? So that is the relevance of why we have got supply into the picture. You would have studied the big definition of supply and all that. That is very much relevant. And when you understand the beauty of it, you will actually appreciate the person who have thought over it, right? Let's go to the next one. Next one is why. Okay, now that we know what is GST, let's study why. Okay, and in why we will cover the trigger. Of why government actually thought of what triggered government to think of GST. VAT was already in place, service tax was already in place, but what made government think so much that they wanted a new tax in all? And it's not easy to bring a new taxation. You have to hire lawyers, you have to hire chartered accountants, and no CAs or lawyers, government, a less cost, you know, everyone is at premium. So they have done a really huge cost involved in this, and they would have anticipated some benefits, and that's why they have done this, right? So next is concept. What is the crux of GST? We will study crux of GST in the concept need. And why was GST needed right now? 1st July 2017, GST was introduced in India. And why it was the right time for having GST, and why not 2021 or back in 2013, right? And the logic of how does it make sense to have the whole new taxation and system than improvising the existing taxation, right? So let's go. I'll give you 15 seconds. Just look at this image and zoom in if you are using your phone, and just think what comes to your mind as soon as you see this, and put a message in the chat box of what comes to your mind with this. You can also turn on your unmute your mic and tell out. What comes to your mind when you see this picture? Saurabh, can we have the chat box on?
Yeah, chat box is on. No one has replied yet. Guys, anyone of you
guys,
can
please take initiative.
Participate.
Anyways, you're going to be at least for the attendance. Okay, anyways, you are here, so please
participate. Guys, you are
because only then it will add value.
And you are future MBA students, guys. If you complete MBA, you need to go. You need to fight in the world to get jobs, everything. If you're not able to speak here, you'll not be able to speak later on also. Guys, anyone of you can just
Trust me, nobody's bothered and nobody's gonna comment on you. It's all about you and me here. Nobody's watching you also. Even if you want to reply as an anonymous person, I'm fine. But please participate so that it opens your mind.
Reply in the chat box also, no problem, guys.
Yeah. Okay, no problem. Nobody has turned up. No problem. It's my duty to have your participation in the...
They are blowing Christmas and making it crepes. There is one student who has turned up. Yeah, she has said that they are blowing Christmas and making it crepes.
Perfect, perfect. I suggest everyone to select everyone when you are writing in the chat box. So, Amruta Patil, you have directly replied to me. Just mention everyone so that everyone is able to read what you're writing. Okay, I guess we are out of time now. So what, if you zoom in, you will see somebody is actually pumping air into dry raisins and making grapes out of it, okay? Which we know is not fact, which we know is not a fact. And this is actually ulta, okay? From grapes, we get raisin. But look at the beauty of creation, how somebody has imagined it. And some, there are two people, the miniatures were actually moving the raisins from here to there, right? So that is how we define why, right? Why is all about our thinking, how we think about it. Now, if you ask Modi government, it will tell GST is a good and simple tax because it is seeing only the positives of GST, right? And if you ask the Congress government, it will tell it is Gabbar Singh tax. You would have heard it in Instagram, Facebook, everywhere, because they are seeing only the negatives, right? So it's all dependent on our imagination, how we can take it. And here, my job for the next 45 minutes is to give the positives, right? Because we are already in the game. We're not here, the lawmakers, to change the game. Now, for example, if you go to the cricket stadium and tell why are the 11 people in the in a team, I want 13 people in the team, I want 15 people in the team, nobody's going to listen to you, right? And if you tell why are there 6 balls in an over, I want 13 balls, I want, say, if there are 11 people in the team, I want 11 balls, one ball each person, nobody's going to listen to you because the rules have been set. We are here, either here to play the game and win or quit. Right. So rather than questioning the negative part of GST or why is it not right or what has gone wrong, if you focus on the positives, I guess the whole life will go in the positive thing, because there's so many positives, because I have been personally studying VAT and GST both, and I know the positives and what are the improvements happening in the economy. I'm no supporter of Modi government or Congress government or anything. I'm a neutral person and I'm here to give you a mindset. I'm here to give you a perspective of how you can think. Of course, people have gone through a lot of trouble when GST had come in, and even now people are suffering. So many new things are coming in, e-invoicing, e-way bill. Every fortnight you have a new update, right? People are facing problems, I don't deny that, but that is for a greater cause, right? We have to go through the worst to get to the better, from the good, right? Fine, let's go to the next slide. So in why, the first question is, why do we anyway have to pay GST, right? So government is so rich, it can mint money, but why do we have to pay GST? So the first reason and the foremost reason is because we use resources. And when I say resources, I mean roads or the infra what government has built, the government colleges, hospitals, everything has been built by money, okay? And to get this money, government has to, it can't mint the money, right? Minting money is all governed by the complete World Trade Organization. And it doesn't happen overnight, right? So that is why we need to pay GST. And the second point is the destination-based tax. So here, I'll tell you the reason behind this. So now, states like Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, right? You all know these are consuming states. There are not a lot of manufacturing industries or factories there, right? There are people with skilled manpower, but these people are not creating anything. They're just consuming. So government found it very difficult to actually share the revenue to these states. So what it told is the now in GST, the tax will move with the product. Like, for example, if I sell something from Gadag to Haryana, okay, the Haryana government gets the tax. If you sell something from Hubli to Lucknow, the Madhya Pradesh government gets the tax. So that's how they have built this. The next one is cascading effects. You would have heard a lot of this word, and I'll just give you an example of how it works. In case now you have an amoeba in Hubli also, in U-Mall, and you have multiple of them in Bangalore also. If before 1st July 2017, you would have seen their invoice, they were charging you four kinds of tax. Okay. The first was the luxury tax. Because playing Amoeba is not a necessity to you. It's not like if you don't play Amoeba, you can't stay. Right? It was a luxury. So they used to charge luxury tax. And the second one was entertainment. So this all is covered under entertainment because it gives a sense of joy. Right? So they used to charge you entertainment tax. The third one was service tax. So this was because there is a person in Amoeba, you remember, who is just around you and to keep the to tell you how to bowl, to tell you how to not bowl. And in case it's a strike and it doesn't appear in the screen up there, you again call him. So he's giving you a service. So they would charge you service tax. And fourth one, VAT. You remember they give you white socks, okay, which they don't take back. They actually sell to you, right? On that they used to charge VAT. So like this, they're charging four kinds of taxes in one single transaction. And so much so that if you pay 200 rupees, okay, actually 80 rupees out of it goes to government. The person is earning only 120, okay, 80 rupees is going to government and you have no clue how to question because it's so complicated. And the other person, the Amoeba guy, he also doesn't have any clue because the rules and laws are changing every day, right? So what they did was, to bring GST, the main reason was simplicity, okay? So that if we have only one tax, the buyer can question the seller and the seller is always clear about what to charge. Right now, if you go to Amoeba, you will see only one tax, GST. Right, so that is the benefit of having GST. The next why is only for businesses. Okay, so now in VAT, we had questions like, for example, you have an old sofa at your back at your home, and you have say TV, and if you sell it to somebody, right, for some consideration, so is VAT applicable on that? Or you have old jewelry of your mom, and she sells it, is VAT applicable on it? So these were the questions which were very ambiguous and there was no clarity on it. So government told, okay, boss, no confusions from now. We want to reduce the case as much as possible. So GST is applicable only for businesses, right? If you're not under a business name and you're doing something at your personal capacity, as growth partners, if I do something, it is taxable. I have a GST number, okay? But as CA Manish Bansali, I do something, it's not taxable, okay? This is my water bottle. Okay. If I sell this water bottle, this is not taxable because I am doing this as my personal capacity. I am not in a business of selling water bottles, right? Fine. Going to the next point, new age businesses. Now, when VAT was introduced, okay, we had very few kinds of businesses and these are all cliche, old style, traditional businesses like purchase and sale. That's all. But now with technology becoming wide, the scope of technology becoming wider and wider, new startups came in like Swiggy, Uber, and Paytm. Now, what is Swiggy doing? Whatever it's buying from the hotel guys, right? It's not eating. The people of Swiggy are not eating, right? And whatever it is selling to the customer, they're not making it. So it's neither buying nor selling. So under VAT, Swiggy used to tell that, boss, I'm not buying, not selling. I'll not charge VAT, right? So even if it is doing business of 100 crores, it's not paying any tax. Swiggy was our client when I was doing articleship and I was in Swiggy for 2.5 months. At that time, it was back in 2016 end, okay? And that time they had, they were only in 7 cities, right? So I know how much they were struggling to understand VAT and what was happening, right? So when GST came, it was all clear for them that, okay, boss, we have to charge GST now. So if they charge you 30 rupees delivery charges, in case they do, so that 30 rupees is inclusive of taxation. If you get to see the invoice sometime, please see. Only if you experience the subject, okay, you will get interest in it. So now going forward, when you go to a garment store and you see, so they would have charged you 5% tax. And if the value of the product is more than 1,000, they would have charged you 12% tax. So if you experience this, it will become more beautiful for you. Let's go to the next slide. I'll again give you 15 seconds. Just visualize this chart. And I again want one word comment from you in the chat box. Just read everything. Yeah. You can select to everyone and put something in the chat box, whatever you feel, what has happened. These are the internet charges in the year 1995 when you and me were born or were not in existence. What comes to your mind when you see this chart? It's just a normal conversation. It's not a seminar or something. Feel free and open to give a reply. I'm of your age only. I'm 26. Whatever comes to your mind. Okay. Somebody's telling simplicity. Fine. Yeah. It's become very simple now. Using internet has become very, very simple now. Cool. 3-4 of you have replied. Now, I'll tell you what I see in this. Okay. Internet has become very, very, very simple over the time. Like, thanks to Ambani family, Dhirubhai Ambani made the incoming free and Mukesh Ambani made the outgoing free for us. Okay. And they've made us it so affordable that I guess now everyone, if it's not a question that do you have internet? The question is how much bandwidth do you have? What is the speed of internet? We no more ask, do you have internet, right? If it's a smartphone or if it's any other phone, they have internet, right? And it has become so with this, it has become so affordable. And look at the simplicity. In 1995, so they had to pay 5,000 rupees for 9.6 kbps dial-up line. Dial-up, by dial-up, it means this broadband what you have. Okay. So they had to pay 5,000 looks so big to us even today. So if I bring in inflation, it is 75,000 after that time, right? So it was so costly. It has become so simple now. It has become so affordable now. And now when you take a Jio data pack of 1.5 GB per day or 2.5 GB per day or whatever, the Jio company never asks you, what are you using it for, right? Whether you are professional or non-commercial or commercial, exporter, service provider, whatever you are, okay? This 1.5 GB, you use it to Netflix, you use it for Amazon Prime, you use it to attend a Zoom session with me, you use it for WhatsApping, for Instagram, Snapchat, whatever. They don't care. All they care is how much have you used, right? So it has become so simple and so many people have joined because of this. Right. So this is the main reason why the government thought of having GST, to make it simpler so that more and more people join the hands with government. Moving on to the next slide. Now we'll discuss the how. Okay. In how we'll discuss the elements of GST, what comes under GST, what are the parts of GST, and the interaction between the elements of how the elements interact internally and with the world outside, and the process, how the computation happens, and the results. Okay, so going down to the next slide. Okay. Again, an image. I don't know what will take away from this session, but these pictures, what I'm showing you, you're not going to forget. I'm sure you're not going to forget this because this actually brings some value to your thinking, right? Now, again, take 5 seconds and if possible, participate now. What comes to your mind when you see this slide? Okay, what is he selling actually? Somebody's telling he's selling flowers. No, he's not selling flowers. Those are for beautification of his bicycle. Perfect. He's selling tea. He's selling chai. Somebody tells it's attractive. Perfect. Great. I'm happy to see the response. So, eye-catching. Perfect. Vishal is telling it's eye-catching. Now, I tell you something. He's not selling tea. He's not selling flowers. He's not selling any that mints or something. No. He's selling happiness. Okay. He's selling happiness. Now, if there are three people standing there selling tea, you will go to this person and you will buy tea. Okay. Because except for his face, okay, he's made a frowning face. I don't know for what. Except for his face, everything in the picture is happy, right? And you would have read this, Dekho Magar Pyar Se. He's written this. He's written it down there also, and he's written it here also. So it's not what are we doing, it's how are we doing, right? So it might be a very trivial thing, but in the beauty of how we do it, the very thing becomes beautiful, right? So now because we have studied what and why of GST, I'll tell you how the GST is actually been calculated and how it's actually been rolled out in the world in India, right? And only when you realize the beauty of how will you actually appreciate the beauty of what and why. Okay, fine. Let's go. I'm happy that you guys are participating. Let's move on to the next slide. Okay. So the first point is all supplies taxable except negative Visa. You would have seen in my presentation till now. So it's been 30 minutes we are together. I've not more mentioned on the facts or exact definition or something, because I think that can be learned from textbook. All we have to learn when we are talking to a person or when you are talking to your professor is how to think about it, right? Because now this MBA, you are in fourth sem, two more sems, and or I guess fourth sem is the final sem for you. So it will get over, right? What next? Saurabh sir is not coming with you all the way, right? But he can leave that thinking pattern in you. So that is what you have to catch, right? Because out there in the industry, when you go out, maybe GST has gone and something else has come. Like in my CA final, I cleared CA final in second attempt. First attempt, I cleared my first group, and second attempt, I cleared in my second group. So when I was writing my first group, we had batter. And when I was writing my second group, we had GST. Okay. So at once, in 1 month, I had to study GST for 75 marks. So that was something very, very, very stressful for me and for all the people in my batch, right? But what beautiful thing I realized is, now I'm still in touch with my GST professor. Okay, and he had taught us VAT with such beauty and such simplicity that I could relate everything with GST. For me, GST, and to put it in the note, I have scored the highest in GST. Okay, of all the 8 subjects in final C, I scored the highest in GST because I was in touch with the subject through the lecturer, of course. Without him, this stone wouldn't be molded, right? He made it so simple and so beautiful that even when VAT turned to GST, I could still relate to VAT. With VAT concepts, I could study GST, right? So now government says all supplies, we studied what is a supply. All supplies are taxable, okay? Except negative list. In negative list, it has given something. So it tells that everything is taxable unless I tell something is not taxable, right? That is what it necessarily means. And the second one, is, second point is the place of supply. So the knowing place of supply is very important because we have to determine the origin and destination. Like I told you, this is a destination-based tax. So if I sell something from Gadag to, for example, Ahmedabad, okay, it has to go via Maharashtra or Madhya Pradesh, however. Now, does Madhya Pradesh government has any benefit in the goods which are moving through Madhya Pradesh? No, right? Does Karnataka government has any benefit of the goods? No. Only benefit goes to the Ahmedabad government, which is the Gujarat government. So that is why knowing place of supply is very important. How, what is, what are the conditions and all that you can learn from the books. I'm not interested to teach you the hard coding. Okay, I am here to change your perspective and give you a thought of this is actually beautiful, right? So next point is rates. So we have 6 rates, which is 0% exempt, 5%, 12%, 18% and 28%. So now government has classified everything under these rates because it believes if we have specific rates, okay, what happened in GST VAT was, it was relevant to states. So whenever a foreign company had to come to India, so they would never get their calculation. Like if now, for example, this Elon Musk, he's coming to India, okay? Had it been in VAT, I don't think he would have ever come to India, okay? Because he believes in simplicity and minimalism, right? Now, because of GST, things are very clear that you have to pay or charge so much tax. What happened in VAT is if he comes to Karnataka, the taxation is this. If he goes to Gujarat, the taxation is this. If he goes to Bengal, the taxation is this. So it would take them more cost to actually study the market than actually producing the stuff they want to produce. Okay. So that is why a lot of foreign investments were not coming to India because it was all so complicated. Now, thanks to the Modi government or the Congress government, which initially started the GST, things have become easier. The life has become simpler, right? So going to the next part, types. So types, we have CGST, SGST, IGST, and UBGST. So you know the definitions of this: central, state, interstate, and union territory. Whenever we are selling something intrastate, like Gadag to Hubli, Hubli to Gadag, Gadag to Koppal, something, or Hubli to Belgaum, we charge CGST and SGST. If the rate is 18%, we charge 9% and 9%. Okay. But the same thing, if we sell it outside Karnataka, okay, we charge IGST. And if we sell it to union territory, say Delhi, Bondi, something, which has UBGST and CGST. Next point is about input tax credit. I have a case study on this, so I'll take it later. And next is computation. Computation you would have studied. It is tax payable is not actually what you charge to your customers. It is your output tax minus your input tax. Next one is, give me a minute. Sorry, thanks. Next one is refund. Government has told about refund, I'll tell you why. So now, say for example, you're buying something and the tax rates are 18%, okay? And when you're selling it, it's exempt. For example, now COVID material, all this masks or sanitizers or something, they've made exempt, okay? So when you're selling it, you're not charging any tax. But when you bought the raw material, when you bought cotton to make the masks, it was actually chargeable, right? So what people do is, now when they can't claim the input, they increase the cost of the product. Okay, and in turn the products become more costlier. So government came into picture and it told, don't increase the cost of product. What we will do is, we'll give you a refund, and it is called inverted duty structure. When what you buy is at a higher rate than what you sell, okay, you are often left with a credit and you can never claim it, because no matter how much masks you sell, you're not making any tax on it, right? But you have paid a lot of tax in buying the threads, cotton, packaging, plastic, transport, logistics, everywhere you have paid tax, but you have not charged anything to your clients, right? That's why this refund feature has come into existence. Going to the next slide. Yeah. So this is a live case study. Okay. I brought it from my own firm. So my firm's name is Growth Partners, and these are the two invoices. Okay, in case you can zoom it, please zoom it from your devices. So these are two invoices. This is intrastate and this is interstate. Okay, first we'll run through the intrastate. Here I want to show what all comes in an invoice also, so that going forward, if your dad has got any business or your brother is doing any business, you can observe things and you can actually experience the magic of this. Okay. The best teacher is experience, and you would have heard it enough times. Now try to visualize this. Okay. So let's start. So left side, the invoice, the first, it is a seller's name. So I'm the seller, Growth Partners, 23 ground floor, Sangeshwar complex. I have to mention my name and address compulsorily as per government rules. This is my GST number. Okay. In GST number 29 is the state code, which is the Karnataka code. And then it's my PAN here. And then there is entity code and checksum character. Then it's Karnataka, the state, and this is my email ID. So the buyer, okay, my client, his firm's name is Mahavir Hardware. We don't buy, for example, if I buy something from somebody, he'll not bill me at CA management side. He'll bill me at Growth Partners, right? Because again, we know the entity is different from the person, right? So Mahavir Hardware, and this person is from Bangalore. So here you have the state code. You have the GST number, Mukesh Kumar, his number, his email ID, everything. I told him something. I've written it because of some confidentiality thing. I've written this is the HSN code. And I've given him a service of 43,200 rupees. And because this service, okay, of this HSN code is taxable at 18%, I've charged CGST and SGST at 9% and 9% each, right? So that is how we charge when the buyer is from Bangalore or in the same state of what the seller is from, right? And now let's come to the second part of it. So here the buyer, if you see, it's Chopra Precision Tools. It's a manufacturing conglomerate in Pune, okay? And this guy is in Maharashtra, and I am the seller, I am in Karnataka. So I can't charge CGST and SGST to him. So I've charged IGST. It's the same product, you can see the HSN code, but the service, the duration was less. So we have charged him 9,600 due to some other conditions. And here it's the same 18%, but I've charged as IGST and I've not charged CGST or SGST. Okay. So this is how it happens practically. And these are not some old dates, say 31st May 2021, last month, 23rd April 2021, which is last month. This is very live. I've given this because only when you see something live will you actually connect to it. Right. And I'll also give you a thing of how, why people do this. So I've given a prefix of GP, which is actually Growth Partners, and a suffix of 2122, because I'll again have invoice number 1, 2, 3, 4 in the next year also. I had it in the last year also, right? So to give a definition of the invoice or a relevance of the invoice, we give the year here. right? Fine. Let's go to the next slide. Okay. This is the flow of credit. Okay. Professor Saurabh also has taught you the same case study, and again, I'll run through the same thing again. So if a manufacturer has got all the goods, okay, by himself, and he manufactures something for which the cost is 1 lakh rupees, and he sells it for 1 lakh rupees, and charges 18% GST. So the GST is 18,000 rupees. GST has to be paid to the government. Okay, we'll say it later in the next part. So GST he'll pay 18,000 rupees, and the another way of calculation is 1 lakh into 18%, 18,000. Right. So next, when it goes to distributor, okay, nobody is doing charity here. Everyone is in a business to make profits, unless it's an NPO or something. So he wants a profit of 11.2%. So he sells it at 1,11,200, and then charges GST at 18%, which is 20,016 rupees. So now the government says whatever you collect as GST has to be paid to me. Okay, doesn't matter when we have to charge 5% GST. Okay, but you by mistake charge 20% or 12% or 18%, something, right? Doesn't matter. Even if you have charged it wrong, but you have collected from the government, you have to pay to us, right? So government tells this distributor that you have charged to 20,016 rupees to your customer, and he has paid to you, so you have to pay to me, right? So distributor is smart. He tells boss, I understand. I'll pay 20,016 to you, but what about the 18,000 what I've paid to manufacturer? Okay, he has paid to you only on my behalf, right? So I'll reduce that. Fair enough. So he reduces 18,000 from 20,016 and pays only 2016. So this is how it is actually happening, right? So if I go back to this, so I have to pay government 388, CGST and SGST, but I'll not pay so much. I would have again taken some consultancy or some other services, right? So say for example, I have taken services where the other person has charged me GST and SGST of 1,000 each. So I pay 2888 and 2888, because why do I have to repay anything, right? Already paid on it, on the services, I'll claim the benefit of it, right? The same way a retailer does and consumer does. The final cost addition boils down to the consumer. Consumers are the people who pay for it finally, because they are the people who actually are not customers, who are the consumers, who the item gets over them, right? Going to the next point, who? So in the who, we will study about the registration, who is liable to register, who is liable not to register, and the responsibilities. If you register, what you have to do, what you have to not do, and the computations, right? Okay, registration. So here, registration, government says that all these Toda players, small businesses who are selling from their homes or who are just reselling on Meesho or something, right? We don't want to burden you. First come up in life, grow a little, and after that you can pay us tax, right? So it has told, considering the data of entire India, it has told that 40 lakhs is the limit up to which you don't have to worry about GST. Tension nahi lene ka. You do your business, okay? Come up in life, grow in life, and only when you have grown, you take a part of your growth, right? You take some GST from you, right? So that's why this 40 lakhs limit, and for some states it's 20 lakhs because there's some specific term, sorry to use the negative term. And next is longitude and latitude. Okay, so I'll tell you the beauty of this. So how GST has been framed is, now for example, GST is also a person, this government is also a person, right? Like we, you and me, government is also a person because it is collecting tax from people, right? But it is not practical for government to go everywhere and reach everywhere and actually question everyone and talk to everyone, right? So, but government can't do it, but Google can do it. Google is the one, right? Google can do it. So government has taken Google Maps help, and it has traced longitude and latitude of everyone. As if the service is there, it's not still applicable and they have not made it valid in the GST portal, but soon they'll do it. In this, what happens is, now, for example, Growth Partners is my office. So the government knows by coordinates, right? So you share WhatsApp location in your maps, in your WhatsApp. So you are actually sharing your coordinates, right? So in GST, there is also a feature where the coordinates can be mapped. So the government sitting anywhere knows where is Growth Partners, right? It knows all the four sides of Growth Partners. That is the power of GST. So this they have done because tomorrow, say for example, I vacate that place. So there's a new construction going on and I go to that place. So the government knows. So now that Manish or group partners is not here, somebody would have come here, right? So if somebody doesn't register with that longitude and latitude again, it will send a person. Go check and come who's doing their business but has not registered with them, right? So this is the power of government. The next point is only businesses. So I told you any personal stuff at personal capacity is not applicable. The GST is not applicable on that. Anything in the name of GST, yeah. So this is also a very interesting topic where what happened when GST was introduced is like everyone had to change their software, right? So service tax was 14% but GST, for example, was 18% on their product. Some people by mistake made it 28% because they were not clear, right? And when the time came to pay the tax to government, they told, but tax is 18%, we will just pay 18%. This 10% is our profit. So government told nothing doing. If you collect anything in the name of GST, you have to pay to us, right? Doesn't matter if you have collected it wrongly or you have knowingly you have collected it more or something like that. If you have collected GST, you have to pay it to us. So that is the rule of law, right? Next point is compliances, where government has told that you have to display your GST numbers, you have to mention HSN codes, display HSN codes. If I talk about HSN code, I can talk for 3 hours. It's such a vast topic and it is so relevant in the coming term because everything can be mapped, right? So the government knows how many, for example, OnePlus 8 are being sold, right? It knows everything, how many this Butterflow pens are sold. It knows everything. So to track all that data, the HSN code things have come into place. And below I've given this GSTN format where state code is 20, for Karnataka it's 29, for Maharashtra it's 27. Like this, every state has their own state code. Next is PAN, which is a 10-digit alphanumeric number. And then it's entity code and checksum character. This one. Next is whom and when. So here we'll study about the returns, GST returns, which is the most interesting part because that is where people make money actually. And then the timing and the refunds. Okay, let's start. So if I hide, I didn't hide this, but you can read this, or probably you can't read this because it's such a big number. So this is the number and this is the amount which government has collected in the form of GST in April 2021. Okay, whatever I'm talking is live. Okay, now we are in June and I'm talking about April, right? This is not very far. The government has collected 1.41 lakh crores out of GST. And this huge amount have been paid by you and me. Okay, last month I have paid around 26,000 or something. So out of this 1.41 lakh crores, my share is 26,000. What is your share? Right. So that is how I see my growth. If I pay more tax, that means I'm growing in my life and in fact contributing to government at large. So to manage so much money at a time, and this is monthly, okay, this is of April. Like this, we have 12 months, and because of lockdown, May and June collections would come down. But for next March 2022, it will be doubled. Customer will be doubled because the kind of booms we are getting and kind of business we are having, it's crazy. Right, going to the next part, who, when and what next. So here government says, now I showed you the invoices, right? So with my calculation, I'll pay the GST. But what if government says that, Manish, I think you have done some mistakes. Okay, I don't believe you. Government will never say this, okay, to me at least, because I don't cheat government. But in case it feels that somebody has cheated government, so it wants to come back and check the records. It wants to come back and check the invoices. So for example, if I've written 18%, but actually the calculation is 28%. Okay. So I'm liable to pay 28%. So all these records and all can be checked only when they are maintained. So government has clearly told whatever invoices, books or whatever you have to maintain it in the system. So that in the system or in physical format, so that whenever we have a doubt, we can come and check. Right. The next one is a filing of returns. So the government has told every businessman to file 3 returns in a month, which is GSTR 1, 2 and 3B. 1 is for sales, what we do. 2 is for purchase, what we have. 3B is a summary where we do this output minus input tax Monday and the actual pay tax. GSTR 2 is right now not mandatory. Okay. And because there are a few settings which have to be done in the government and which will be done over time. Right now, it's not applicable. But 1 and 3B, everyone, it's applicable for every business who is registered under GST. And they have to pay taxes in GST 3B. Next one is e-way bill. Okay. So what happened is now to stop this parallel economy, okay, this black economy, the tracking is more important, right? So government introduced e-way bills. So e-way bills is not any other new bill. So whenever you, government says, whenever you sell something, now for example, this phone, okay, whenever you sell some goods worth more than 550,000, okay, then you have to attach an e-way bill which tells how these goods are moving. So that anytime government wants to track, it can actually track, right? So like, for example, if you put something for DTDC or professional courier or something, you can go and track the thing, right? Where it has reached or where it has not. So that is how you can do it in e-way bill also. So that's why e-way bill has been introduced, so that people are always aware that somebody is looking at them and the chances of fraud or errors come down, right? In the heading, if you see, I've written what next also, right? So these three points are not there in your syllabus at all, but I want to give you a touch of it, a flute of it, because I want to take you to take away what's next. Because when till the time you go to the industry, next 6 months, 8 months down the line, it will be difficult for you if you're not updated, right? You have to be always updated. And now that you're doing MBA, people have expectations from you. Forget people, you have expectations from your own self, right? So that is why you have to be, I have a few tips. Okay, I guess this is the right time. One is read newspaper, and I mean physical newspapers. Okay, get any newspaper. It wouldn't cost you 300 to 500 rupees per month. Okay, which is less than your data pack. Okay, get it, feel it, be with the newspaper for 10 minutes. Read anything. You like cricket, read about cricket. You like about politics, read about politics. Read anything, but stay in touch with newspapers, because what physical newspaper can do, all your online notifications and updates can never do, right? So this is one of the tips from my side. And second tip, based on these three points, is start working on something more, right? Now you guys are doing MBA. 6 months down the line, you will go into the industry and you will probably have an employment, or you will start something of your own, whatever. If you want to be ahead than people who are with you, okay? And I'm not seeing this as a competition. This can also be a collaboration, okay? You have to do something more. When I say something more, I don't mean you have to earn, no. Your parents are supporting you right now, it's fine. You earn, it's very good, but don't do it for earning. You can do something like internship, and even free internship. A lot of people are providing internship, free internships. You can do free internships or do anything you like, but be visible. Okay. Like, for example, if you like sharing memes on Instagram and you are making memes yourself, make a page on Instagram of, say, Meme Bazaar or whatever. Now, there is a page by name Hubballi, okay, Hubballi_LE. Okay, so this guy is charging 2,500 rupees per post if you want to promote stuff on this. Okay, I'm not asking you to make a meme page, but we have to build a distribution and we have to build a visibility, right? So say I have 1,000 people in my contacts and I want to sell this pen. I know 10 people will buy it at least, but what if I have only 100 people in my contact, right? Only one might buy it. So it's very important to build network. More than the product, it's very important to build the distribution. So once you have the distribution, it will be easier for us to build whatever product we want to, right? And stay connected on Twitter or platforms like that, which is off this glamour and all there, where you are actually learning value, okay? And you can track your screen time, how much you're spending time on WhatsApp, everything. So use those tools to have a better insight, because we are in the game, like I told you. We are in the chess, and here you can't question why king, being the so powerful of all, can move only one step at nine, and why queen can do what she does, or why elephant can move only straight, or why camel can move otherwise, can't move otherwise. Or you can't question anything. You are here to play the game. You have to play the game and you have to win the game, right? We can't question anything. So that's why these are a few tips from my side. Okay, coming back to the topic, e-invoicing. So government has recently brought this into picture, where it started from people who have turnover of 500 crores and more. Okay. And within 1 year, they brought it down to 50 crores and more. So if there's a business which is doing a turnover of 50 crores of and more per year, so they have to do e-invoicing. What is e-invoicing is? Technically, it's very, very beyond comprehension. I'll tell you what it means simply. It means if I want to sell this, again, I'm taking pen, let me take a book. If I want to sell this book, okay, before selling it to you, I have to tell government that I'm selling this to you. Okay. So now what happens in GST is whenever I sell something, next month 11, I file the return. So the government doesn't get to know about it for 41 days. If I sold something on Jan 1st, up to Feb 11, government won't come to know about it. But what happens in e-invoicing is, if I've sold today, the government gets to know today before the buyer gets to know, right? So this is giving real-time benefit of knowing. And if there are any frauds, so a fraud can be minimized if the government knows today than compared to knowing after 41 days, right? So that is the idea. So e-invoicing is a beautiful concept. You should go and read about it. And trust me, I'll give you one hack. Don't watch any YouTube videos in the normal speed of what they have uploaded, unless it is a person not from Indian origin speaking. Okay, everyone makes big videos because they want more view time so that they can earn more. Watch all the videos in 1.25x and 1.5x or 1.75x if the speaker is really slow, right? So that you can actually save time. If you watch it in 1.25x, 1 hour thing, you are watching it in 15 minutes. Okay, it's just 10 minutes, but you won't lose the interest for 15 minutes. You're just, and you feel there's something which you have to skip it. It's not necessary that you religiously do it, you start and you end. No, you like something, you like Bitcoin, you go search Bitcoin and learn about it. Put in 1 hour. Okay. It doesn't matter. You are not here to give exams. But if you have interest in it, go make a page. If you think you are doing stock market trading or something, go make a page and tell people what you know, right? Bring some visibility, and you don't know where the opportunity can take you, right? Going to the next point, radio frequency identification device. Okay, this will blow your mind. What this is now, for example, whenever I'm selling something and it goes through some logistics, right? Through VRL, DRL or whatever. These are the famous logistics in India. So whenever I'm selling something and it goes to logistics, so by e-way we got to know that, okay, everything has to be tracked, whatever is above 50,000. But there was some limitation. What could be tracked is whether it has left from, when it has left from Hubli and when it will reach Gadag. These two things I can track from e-way bill. Through RFID, what they did is, they gave a tag to the truck, which was actually bringing the goods. Okay, so now I'm able to track where is the truck. Is it in Anigiri? Is it in Hulkoti? Or where has it reached? Has it crossed the bridge? Has it crossed the court circle? Where it is exactly, I can track. And this is again getting linked with the fastags, and e-way bills are also getting connected to the e-invoicing part. So the future is really mesmerizing, because now whatever we feel, there is so much of documentation, work, papers and all that. All that will go in a few days time, because in a few months time, because government is really looking forward for something really great. Okay. And the last point is live updates with government. So with all these invoicing, e-way bill, radio frequency, identification device, government wants a live tracking of stuff. Okay. Because the prevention is better than cure, right? If I know it now and I do something about it, it gives a lot of scope to actually save upon the fraud, right? So that's why government is focusing on that. And I guess we have covered almost everything what I thought of Monday, and we are on time. It's been 58 minutes. So lastly, but not the least, I would like to tell you, we don't need new eyes. We have beautiful eyes. We only need new spectacles. Okay. We have to read the same thing with a new mindset. And for that, we have to have a perspective. We have to, and if you think I'm getting stuck in some perspective, go approach your professors. You have beautiful professors at your reach. Go connect to them, ask them. And it's not necessarily now, it's not necessary that you ask only GST doubts to your professor Saurabh. Okay. He is a chartered accountant. He is doing a lot of, he is a multitasker. He's doing some 10 things in life. Okay. He's got a fair idea about everything. Stay in touch with them. Like what, how, when I had done IIM, I'm still in touch with the professors. Okay. And whenever I have some issues and difficulties in my startup, okay, I contact them and they give me their view. Okay. And that really expands my thinking, because I can think, acha, aisa bhi ho sakta hai. So I would never have thought about it. And only because of their involvement, I could get that plate. Okay. I would take the liberty to give you, to suggest to you guys one book. I'll just share it in the chat box. Yeah. So I'll share it in the chat box. You guys can copy it and paste it somewhere. Yeah. So this is an operation strategy book. This book is by a professor who taught us in IIM. Okay. This book, I have been reading it, and this is the book. Okay. I've knowingly kept it near me because I can actually suggest to you guys. What this does is, this book or any book you read, okay, but read books which change your perspective. Now in this book, the lecturer has related all the operational strategies to live animals. Okay, so for example, we had a session in IIM where the professor played a cheetah video for 10 minutes. For 10 minutes, we were all sitting, 35 of us, we were just sitting and watching the cheetah run, watching the cheetah drink water, watching the cheetah hide when some stronger animal comes. Okay, and it's very different from how other animals do it, right? And when he once linked it to cheetah, after that he left us freehand. He didn't have to tell us anything, and we could imagine everything based on the linking of cheetah. Because now I'll give you one example. Whenever cheetah hides, it doesn't hide to hide itself. It hides to attack. Okay, so this is very different from deer. Okay, deer, what it does is it hides to make itself invisible, right? But it's not the same with cheetah. Okay, so now Geo, Geo has come in. So whenever they do something, they do in attacking pose, right? So they have so much money, all their strategies, they're all well thought. So I suggest you either try this book or any other book which gives you a perspective over stuff and which gives you a new spectacles to look at the same thing. Okay, the only expertise in a person is the number of perspectives that he has got, right? So you don't have to study 10 books. Study one book in 10 different ways, or talk to 10 people who have studied the same book. Okay, you would get the flavor of it and you would understand the beauty of it. With this, I rest my words saying, hope GST looks beautiful to now after all this cosmetics. And it is very pretty, it is very, very beautiful and very close to my heart. I feel you also take it up forward and spread this in your circle. Thank you again, Saurabh, Professor Saurabh and Kaylee ISMR for giving me this opportunity to have words with the students of yours. Thank you.
Thank you, CA Manish Bansali, for your time.
Hello, Manish Bansali, sir.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello, yes, Manish Bansali, sir. I am Professor Jay Siri from KL IMSR. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Very thankful from on behalf of our institute and student. So I think today students have been enlightened with the GST. So which is the name is very sweet and smart, GST. But it is when you go into the depth, it is an ocean, you know. Just giving some brief, awareness about these things. And I hope students have learned certain part of it. And they will take further, we will have this so many such opportunities. Only we can request you be on the behalf of institute. Whenever you get such, opportunity, please be with the, student. So anyway, you will be having a lot of professional work. We do hope it should develop still better, much better. But apart from that, you have to find some time and please, guide our student in the future course also. Yeah, so we are thankful definitely on behalf of your issues.
Definitely, sir. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. And I hope I've made a little difference to all of you. And if I have made, just I have only one thing in return I want from you. That is, you read more and more, or not read more and more, but have more and more perspectives over the same thing what you already know.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Shri, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Munish, for your wonderful time. We had a lot of good things we have learned here. I hope our students will follow these things for their lifetime. And two important things which you have suggested us, that is reading books. Reading books is a wonderful thing, guys. You get a lot of knowledge and it will help you out in your later fights. And the second thing is GST, which he has explained in a very beautiful concept. That is, according to him, the future aspects which will be there in your future generations, as GST is molding more and more we will find many other changes. So thanks for that, and it was glad. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. I'm listing my social media handles below, because if you guys want to connect to me, you can connect there. And if you ever like my perspective, then you can also contribute to the like-minded community what I'm building on Twitter. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All 49 of you are still there. I think I have done a little good part. So I'm happy. Thank you for connecting. And thank you, Saurabh, once again. I'll take a leave.
You have really done a wonderful part, Manish. No doubt about it. And thanks a lot for your wonderful time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.